Hello friends, let's talk about another numerical from Bell Design. The problem statement goes like this. A flat belt is used to drive the compressor by using electric motor, which has following specifications. Power is given as 25 kW. Input speed 1000 rpm, output speed 250 rpm, center to center distance 3 meter, expected life 1.5 years, duty hours that is 14 to 16 hours. Find the cross section of the belt and length of the belt. So let's write down the data. As P is equal to 25 kW, N1 is 1000 rpm, N2 is 250 rpm, C that is center to center distance is 3 meter. That is 3000 mm, life is given as 1.5 years and duty hours are 16 hours. So step number 1, to calculate design power, it is given as P is equal to P multiplied by FA, where FA is load correction factor. Since the given data is machine is compressor, therefore the load is going to be intermittent load. So I select FA as 1.3. So I can write down P is equal to 25 multiplied by 1.3. Therefore, the value of design power is 32.5 kilowatt. Step number 2, selection of pulley diameters. In this, let's find out first of all driver pulley diameter, that is small d. Most efficient power transmission is obtained between the belt speed of 17.5 meter per second to 22.5 meter per second as given on 7.54 of PSG. So this you can see from the graph of power versus V. So taking an average of 17.5 and 22.5, I get the value of V as 20 meter per second. The belt transmit maximum power if the speed of the belt is 20 meter per second. I know the value of velocity as pi d into n1 upon 60. So after substituting the value of v as 20, I get the value of d as 0.38197 meter, that is diameter as 381.97 mm. Taking the standard value of small d from the PSG data book, I select D is equal to 400 mm. Next, to find driven pulley diameter, that is capital D. So the formula is capital D is equal to small d into N1 upon N2 multiplied by eta, that is transmission efficiency. We have assumed here 0.98. So if I substitute the values in the above formula, I get the value of capital D as 1568 mm. Taking the standard value of capital D from the PSG, I select capital D is equal to 1600 mm. The reduction ratio I is given as capital D is equal to small d multiplied by I into eta. So I substitute the value of capital D as 1600, small d as 400 and eta as 0.98. So I get the value of I, that is reduction ratio, as 4.0816. Next step is to calculate the length of the belt. So we know the formula for length of the open belt as L is equal to 2C plus pi by 2 into D plus D plus capital D minus small d bracket square divided by 4C. After substituting the values in the above formula, I get the value of length of the open belt as 9261.59 mm, that is 92616 mm. Next step is to calculate the belt tension. So for that, if I know the formula for arc of a contact, that is theta, as 180 minus capital D minus small d upon C multiplied by 60 degree, after substituting the value of capital D as 1600, small d as 400 and C as 3000, I get the value of theta as 156 degree or 2.7227 radians. The arc of contact correction factor FC is calculated by interpolation. So in a table given below, if you can see arc of contact for different angles, that is 150 degree, 156 degree and 160 degree, I get the correction factor as 1.13, 1.1 and 1.08 respectively. So if I use the interpolation formula and rewrite as 160 minus 150 divided by 156 minus 150 as 1.08 minus 1.13 divided by FC minus 1.13, then I can get the value of FC as 1.1. I know the formula for ratio of driving tension as T2 upon T1 as e raised to power mu theta, where mu is considered as 0.25 for cast iron pulley and leather belt. So writing the values of mu and theta, I get the T1 as 1.9752 T2. I know the formula for power as T1 minus T2 into V. After substituting the value of power as 32.5 into 10 raised to power 3 and T1 as 1.97 T2 and V as 20, I get the value of T2 as 1666.31 Newton, and this represents the tension in slack side. After finding out the value of T2, I can calculate T1 as 1.9752 into 1666.31. So the value of T1, that is tension in the tight side, is 3291.3 Newton. Next step is to find the cross section of the belt. Before that, let's calculate the life in hours. The formula for life in hours given as life in years multiplied by months in a year multiplied by working days in a month multiplied by working hours in a day. So in this case, life in years is given as 1.5. Months are 12 months in a year. Then working days is assumed to be 25 and working hours in a day is considered as 16, that is given. So from this, I can get the answer for life in hours as 7200 hours. Next, life in number of stress cycle is given by the formula LC is equal to V upon L into life in hours multiplied by 3600 multiplied by number of pulley. So LC is equal to 20 upon 9.2616 multiplied by 7200 multiplied by 3600 multiplied by 2. So I get the answer for LC as 11.2 into 10 raised to power 7 cycles. Next is to find maximum stress in a belt, that is sigma max. So the formula is sigma max is equal to sigma t plus sigma b plus sigma c. So writing the formula for sigma t as ta upon a plus et upon d for sigma b, and for sigma c as rho v square into 10 raised to power minus 6. So I know the formula sigma minus 1 upon sigma max whole raised to power m is equal to LC upon 10 raised to power 7, where m is equal to 6 for the flat belt, m is equal to 8 for V belt, and sigma minus 1 is given as 9 Newton per mm square for the flat belt. So with this, I get the value of sigma max as 6.0169 Newton per mm square. So the next thing is to find the number of plies. So from equation 2, I can write as 6.0169 is equal to 3291.3 divided by NP into B plus 1000 into NP upon 400 plus 1000 into 20 square multiplied by 10 raised to power minus 6. And I get the equation in the form of NP and B. Let us call this equation as the equation number 3. So let us find the number of plies and the width of the belt by trial and error method. In this table, you can find that we have calculated under NP into B by equation number 1. We have calculated the value of B. Then we have selected the value of B from the PSG. We have got the value of NP into B standards. And on all these parameters, we have done a check. So for NP is equal to 3, you can see that this criteria fails. Whereas for NP is equal to 4, NP is equal to 5, and NP is equal to 6, the values we have calculated as per the table are safe. Since the aim of the design is to select the wide and a thin belt, hence we will select number of plies, that is NP is equal to 5, width of the belt as 152 mm and the thickness of the belt, that is T, as 5 mm. So dear student, this way we have found out the different parameters required in the numerical. Thank you.